But we always do, and it's like a party. Stick around. I guarantee you'll have fun today. On my left, winning money for the blue section. First time with us, too.
Yes.
Kolchak himself. Huh. There he is. Mr. Darren McGavin and his wife, Kathie Browne. You can see what a favorite that show is because even the yellow and the red section applauded.
There you go.
Sections are applauding.
You see, now that just proves it right there. How are you, Kathie? It's nice to have you with us today.
Terrific, thank you.
You're going to have a good time, you'll see.
Yeah.
Right, Darren?
Sure, baby.
I don't know about your kids, but boy, my kids never miss your show. Ever. They love it so much. Winning money today for the banana section. Back again with us after a long absence, and he's in a disguise, but you recognize him anyway. Mr. Ross Martin and his lovely wife, Olavee.
Thank you. I got all dolled up for this, you know.
Yeah, that was an enthusiastic welcome, too.
Yeah, I don't know what it is. You must clue them in pretty well.
No, not at all. They're just glad to see you, that's all. Olavee, how are you, darling?
Oh, just fine. It's so
I
nice
heard
being
you've been,
back.
You've been running at Del Mar, I heard.
Ah.
Hey, yes. My
Explain
father
that.
Was, well, my father was a little shocked to hear it on the radio. Olavee Martin, there the rail coming in. There's a horse named after me, and I'm very pleased and flattered.
Isn't that terrific?
Yes.
Olavee Martin.
Next to Olavee and Ross, winning money today for the red section. Old friends, haven't been here for a long time. Jerry Stiller and his wife, Anne Meara. Well, welcome to you both. Here you both are from the big city out in California working. You both have series on CBS. Isn't that terrific? Jerry, yours is Joe and Son?
With Richie Castellano, yes.
Yes.
And my wife, she wouldn't say it, but I'll tell you. It's
I would say it. Give me a chance. I'll say
Let
it.
Annie say it. Say it, Anne.
I play a lawyer. Do you believe that?
Yes, I believe
Kate McShane is the name of the show.
Kate McShane, and we'll be watching for that.
Thank you.
CBS in the fall. All right, gang, if you're ready, ladies, the first question's for you. It's worth $150 to your rooting sections. This is it. Ladies, your husband gives you a present of a sexy nightgown that you really don't like. Would you keep it and wear it for him, or would you return it for a style that you like? That's a good question. Your husband gives you a present of a sexy nightgown. You don't like it. Would you keep it and wear it for him, or would you return it for a style that you like? Think it over, and we'll come back in a moment and find out. Off they go. Here we go. It's not too difficult. What would she do in a case like that?
Oh, boy.
It's easy for you. It's difficult for me.
Well, is this? Well, I mean, that's...
What would Kathie do now?
Kathie would keep it, but not wear it.
Oh, but she wouldn't want to hurt your feelings.
She wouldn't return it, but she wouldn't wear it. She'd keep it.
So she would keep it, which is the answer. She wouldn't wear it.
That's right.
But if you have to go for one half of one of the answers, you'll say she would keep it.
She would keep it, but not wear it.
Keep it. That's not on my card, Darren. No. You understand. Here we go, gang.
That is a third category.
No, that's what she'd do. You asked me.
But I think your best to go is she'd keep it. And she'll probably add and wear it for him if she has to.
Absolutely.
Yeah, if you get out the whips and say, wear that sexy
Never
one.
Do. Actually, if she doesn't wear it, well, that's another story.
I see. See, that's how we get things out of you. We tricked her right into that, didn't we? Let's bring on Kathie. Kathie, what are you going to do? Darren gives you a very sexy nightgown. He thinks you don't like it. You're going to keep it and wear it for him, or you're going to take it back for something that you like?
I'm gonna keep it and wear it for him.
That's it. But I think she has something to add.
I might later, if it was something I really didn't like, I might ask him if, you know, sort of, we could have another one.
If we could negotiate
right.
The point, huh?
Find
you don't have to negotiate
one.
On that. You have a share of the pot. Ross, what will Olavee do?
Well, Olavee's a great diplomat. But also a very mature lady.
Yes.
She doesn't tend to wear what she doesn't like. She would come to me and say, honey, it's beautiful, but it really isn't what I enjoy. Would you mind if I exchanged it? She'd ask permission, but she would change it for something she liked.
Right. Has this ever happened to you? Have you ever bought her something like that?
Many times.
Let's bring that lady on here. Olavee, Ross has gotten you a nightgown, sexy. But you don't really like it. What are you going to do? You're going to keep it and wear it for him, or are you going to take it back and get a style that you like?
Well, Because it's a sexy nightgown, it's meaningful and it's special. And even if I don't like it, I'll keep it and I'll wear it.
Wrong. That's not what Ross said. Interesting what he did say. Tell all of you what you said, Ross.
Honey, I said that you were very diplomatic, but also very grown up. And that what you would say to me is, it's a lovely thing, but it isn't exactly what I want. Would you mind if I exchanged it for something I want?
Ross, you're in for some good times, though.
No.
I am going out and buying all the sexy nightgowns I can.
Yes, there's a little shop on Hollywood Boulevard I'd like to recommend to you. Sorry about that, Olavee.
That's all right. He doesn't know what I said, though, does he?
No, yeah, sure he does.
Oh, well, you heard that. Oh,
yeah,
okay.
He heard it.
Yeah. Yes. If it had just been a nightgown, yes, I would take it back. But because it was special.
A sexy one, yeah. I understand. All right.
Okay.
You're still wrong, but nevertheless.
Yeah, that's all right.
Jerry,
sorry, yellow section.
What will Anne do?
Oh, first of all, if I brought in a sexy nightgown, she would be absolutely insulted by the idea that she had to be dressed up in order to appeal to me, Jerry Stiller.
You see, it's around.
That's and so in my we've been married over years, and I never dared do that. I would tell you right now, she if I did it, she would say, "Smut, you're lewd, you're terrible, and wear it yourself," which I would do, and they would turn around and make her very happy. So that's my. That's my application.
I think your answer was that she would take it back and get something she liked.
No, she...
That's not what your answer was.
Kick me right out of the house.
No, but you have to make a choice of either one of my answers on the card here, see. Would she keep it and wear it for you, or would she take it back and get a style that she likes?
The second.
Would she take it back and get a style she likes?
You figure it out.
Or a style that you like.
Not the first.
Because you might want to wear it.
Not the first, right.
Not the first, the second one.
Right.
Bring her on before I forget the whole thing altogether. And Jerry gives you a sexy nightgown. He's crazy about it. You don't like it. Are you going to keep it and wear it for him, or are you going to take it back and get a style that you like?
He asked me to wear a lot of crazy things, you know. I would wear it if it had feet in it.
When was the last time I asked you to wear anything?
You are an animal.
Yes, he is. Sorry about that. Guess what? Kathie and Darren got the whole thing for the blue section. A lot more pots to go. Don't miss it. See you in a second. Here we go. Question number two coming up. Kathie and Darren got all the money, ladies. You got to catch up. This one's worth $150 to your rooting sections, too. Ladies, with whom do you make friends more easily? People who are younger than you are, or people who are older than you are?
That's dumb.
Why, that makes me laugh. With whom do you make friends more easily? People who are younger than you are, or people who are older than you are. Doesn't mean that you go in that category, but we put it in that category. So if you have to think of it that way, try to do your best. Off you go.
That's a terrible choice.
Yes, it is. Well, this is an either you're damned either way on this one.
Yeah. Are you asking that of us now?
I'm asking you what she will
me?
Say. No, I'm not asking you. I'm asking Ross first.
Oh,
you're going to start with me.
Well, because I can see Darren's a little hostile already, and I'm not going to...
You're getting almost the same from me, because her ability to make friends goes across the spectrum without
that's true.
Any difficulty
at all. I can speak for that. She's a gracious, lovely
hostess.
She's
incredible. And I think mostly because there are more young people around than older people around, I would say that her answer would be younger people.
Okay, if she has to make a choice, and we're asking you to do that, and I know it's difficult, Darren, you're going to say younger.
Yes.
Okay, let's bring her on, see what she says. It's a tough choice, and one that you really don't ever have to make consciously, probably, but if you had to, with whom do you make friends more easily, do you think, Olavee, younger people or older people?
I think younger people.
That's it!
You can tell from the reaction what I said, honey.
You got it all right. You see, the bananas are crazy about you at this moment, too. Jerry, how about Anne? What would she say to this?
Well, it really doesn't matter whether they're young or they're old. If they're nice people and Anne loves people, she's what you call a gregarious person. And that is the predominant reason. So I think... it's a wild answer here, and I don't want to...
You know, it's like I'm going to toss it up here. Anybody in the audience want to give me an answer? I'll go with it. She loves old people. That's why she hangs out with me, all right?
You're going to say older people.
Older people.
Okay, yeah, let's bring her on and see what she says.
All right.
Okay. Shh, don't give it away now. Don't say a word.
Anne. Sound is awful.
Anne, with whom would you say that you make friends more easily? I know it's a tough choice.
Yes, it is.
But younger people or older people?
Well, I want to win the money. I don't know what to say. I think younger people.
No, that's not the joke. Well, you had a 50-50 shot,
Anne. Anne, you answered the same way I thought, but I said the other word.
Why? Why did you do that? If that's what you thought, why didn't you say it? This is for the Bucks here.
Jerry, he's thinking it over now.
It's too late.
Yeah, it's too late. Want a second chance, Jerry?
No, I made my choice. That's it.
Roll again.
You're older than me, Jerry, and
I'm
not friends
that
with you.
No.
Darren, you're up. Darren, what's Kathie going to say?
Well, I think Kathie will probably say that we make friends more quickly with older people than we do with younger people.
Now, easily is the word. You are aware of that.
Yes, I understand that.
Okay. You'll say older people. Let's bring the lady on. Kathie?
Yes?
With whom do you make friends more easily, would you say? People younger than you or people older than you?
People younger, but I plead the fifth.
What? She said people younger, but she pleads the fifth.
That's not right, but why do you plead the fifth? You mean you don't want to answer that all again?
Well, I think, I don't understand it.
You don't have to. You're wrong anyway. It doesn't make any difference.
I'm sorry out there.
All
I'm
of me
really
and Ross
sorry.
Are right. They get the whole pot, gang. And it's halftime. We'll change places, fellas. Step to the rear. We'll bring the ladies out front. While we change places, we'll come back with the second half. Please go back with us. Off we go. We've changed places at halftime, and one of the ladies in the banana section just told Anne Meara she looked beautiful. Now, that's sportsmanship, gang, because that's not even in the right section. Good night.
Well, I want to thank Paul, who did my makeup, and the lady who did the hair.
Yeah.
4 hours.
You
four
see?
Hours.
That's class, boy, when the banana section says the red section looks good. Here we go.
The banana section's a very nice section.
Oh, they're classy. Classy folks. Are you kidding? But I do have to tell you, they've been known to turn. They can turn on you really quick. Here we go, fellas. This question's for you. It's worth $150. A deputy sheriff in a small town catches you in a speed trap and gives you a ticket for $10, which you can pay then and there, on the spot. You are completely innocent, and you can prove it. Would you spend a day in court for the principal of the thing or pay the man the $10? Okay? A deputy sheriff in a small town catches you in a speed trap and gives you a ticket for $10, which you can pay then and there on the spot, but you are completely innocent and you can prove it. Would you spend a day in court for the principal of the thing or pay the man the $10 and forget about it? Think about it, fellas. That's a good choice. We've probably all been faced with that in one way or another.
Are they allowed to do that?
In a small town, I believe the guy could be a constable. He could probably take
the whole... I don't think they could do
that. Don't complicate it now.
She's doing a lawyer show.
Yes, that's right. You're right. She's living her part, isn't she?
Extenuating circumstances. Now, what if his wife was having labor pains?
Now, wait a minute here. I tell you, this is a tough group today. Answer the question, lady. What do you think, Anne?
Oh, it's on me first.
Yes, we're going to go with you since you're interested in this one.
What part of the country? No, because we once got stopped in a speed trap. They used to have speed traps.
Yes.
I mean, there were friendly people that told us to watch out for them. Uh-huh. A little town called Ludowice.
Ludowice?
Ludowice on the Hunta and Jessup in Georgia, I think.
Yeah.
I think Jerry would, but I have to think what Jerry would do,
right?
That's right,
exactly.
I think he would really want to fight for his rights, but be scared to death and pay the $10. I think that's what he did. He did in Ludowice.
Well, anything that's right, so goes Ludowice, so goes the country, I think. Let's bring on Jerry. Jerry.
Yes.
What would you do now? You can pay the $10 on the spot and forget about it, or you can go spend a day in court and prove that you were right, you were not speeding. What would you do?
Oh, I'd pay the $10.
That's it.
Yes.
With
my face, I'd pay $15. I used to fight for things like that. I went through such tsuras, as they say.
You won, honey. You won.
Okay. You won. You got the money. Don't worry about it. Kathie, what would Darren do?
I know. For all the blues out there, I know what he would do. He would fight to the death.
I had a hunch we were going to say that.
Absolutely.
He would go to spend that day in court and win.
If it took 2 years, right. He would stay there.
Okay, let's bring him on and see what he says. Darren, you've gotten the ticket from this guy. He says, now look it, buddy, you can give me the $10 here and now and forget about it, or you can go to court and fight about it. You know you're innocent. What are you going to do?
I'm fighting to the
end. That's it!
What? Incidentally, he did that once. He had a law changed in Florida. He went through.
Not only
he
that,
did.
I had a judge.
He went through the whole thing 2 years. Cost him a fortune, but it made him very happy.
I also had a court clerk thrown out of office in New Jersey for the same thing.
There you go. Okay. Don't mess with Kolchak, gang. That's
right.
That's the message there. You're right. You have a share of the pot for the blue section, Olavee. What would Ross do?
You're going to ask him exactly the way you asked Darren.
Yeah, sure. You want me to put it that way?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
He would fight for it.
He would fight?
Yes.
All right, let's bring him on and see what he says. Ross, you go, you get a ticket. The guy's right there. He says, all right, you can give me $10 right now and forget about this thing, but you were not speeding and you know you can prove it. Would you go and spend a day in court, or would you give him the $10 then and there?
I'm a little unclear about something, Bert.
Yes. What?
When you said the guy said, give me $10, is that like a bribe?
No, sir. That was the fine.
Oh,
the fine would be $10.
The fine is $10.
And you can pay it right to him
right
there.
And he gives you a receipt?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, I'm at the stage in my life where I husband what I'm going to protest about. I guard with care where I expend my energies in protest.
Uh-huh.
I can only tell you that $10 is big enough for me to say he's not going to get it.
We'll come back in a minute with our $300 question and decide today. Come on back. Off we go. This one worth $300, and we'll decide it. Now, Ann and Jerry, you know you can still win, even though you have $50, because this one's worth $300. If you get the whole thing, you got it. Okay? Off we go. It's for you, fellas. Which of you do you think has more insight into the problems of others, you or your wife? Which of you do you think has more insight into the problems of others, you or your wife? Think it over. Good question. Off they go, and we'll start with you, Ann, between you and Jerry.
I want to be honest, so we win. You got that, red team? So I don't want this to sound like an ego trip, because he's a good listener. But my answer is, I think he would go along and say, I had more insight into the problems of others.
Right.
I think he would say that.
Okay, let's bring him on, see what he says. Here he comes now. Jerry, between you and Ann, who do you think has more insight into the problems of others?
Ann definitely has
more insight. That's it. You got it.
Thanks, sweetheart.
You're very, 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 very sensitive to others, her own children, her own family.
It's no testimonials.
But not to me.
Like
you did it. Yeah, but not to you. Kathie, what about Darren? Between you and Darren.
I think that Darren would say that I had.
That you had more insight into the problems of others. Let's bring him on and find out. Here we go. Darren, between you and Kathie, who would you say has more insight into the problems of others?
It's a dead pipe cinch, Kathie.
That's it.
Of course. I'm dumb.
Oh, yes. You're cooking, I'll tell you that. Olavee, how about Ross, between you and Ross?
I think he'll say the same thing. I think he'll say that I do.
He'll say that you do. Interesting, the men are saying the women.
That's gentlemen.
Is that what it is? Let's bring him on and find out. Ross,
yes.
This will decide the game, sir. I don't want you to feel any pressure. The other two couples have gotten it correctly. Between you and all of you, who has more insight into the problems of others?
No question about it. I do.
No, wrong. There is some question about it. I'm sorry, Ann and Jerry, Kathie and Darren split the pot in half. That signal means time is up. The blue section has won it. We'll be back in a moment to let you know exactly how much Kathie and Darren have won. Darren and Kathie won it today for the blue section, $350. We had 1,000, a total of 1,350 big ones. Thank you, everybody. You were splendid. See you next time on Tattletales. Goodbye, everybody. Bye-bye.
This is Gene Woods speaking for Tattletales, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.